What's going on? It's Young Reno, the rookie chef. And I'm back again with another one, y'all. This time I had a taste for a T-bone steak, right? And I'm going to do something special with the potato that I'm going to have on the side, okay? What we're going to be doing right now is we're going to be doing a T-bone steak with Hasselback potato, okay? Y'all know what a Hasselback potato is? If you don't, you'll find out at the end. It's just a special way you do the potato, and I think it's going to go good with this steak the way I'm going to do it, okay? So that's what we got. T-bone steak with a Hasselback potato. Let's look at the ingredients. We got a nice juicy T-bone steak right there. We got butter. We got that insane steak cracked pepper seasoning, roasted garlic and herb, black peppercorn, spicy Montreal steak, sea salt, crushed red pepper, steak sauce, of course, and that baked potato that we're going to turn into a Hasselback potato at the end. That's all we got. That's all we got. And it's going to be super fast. So without further delay, let's get it in. All right, y'all. The first we're going to do is we're going to tenderize this T-bone steak and get it ready. Y'all already know, you remember, I'm the legal person when it comes to the steak, to the tenderizing. You remember, I'm the cook with the gravel. All right. So let's go ahead and start tenderizing this up with the sharp pointy sides. So basically, we're just going to do that. Get it nice and tenderized. So, because I'm going to be putting this in my conventional oven. That's how we're going to do it. We're going to broil it in that. You know, turn it over. Same thing. There we go, y'all. Okay. And basically what I do is I just only season the top. I don't season both sides. So what we got here is our cracked pepper, insane steak cracked pepper seasoning. Put that over there like that, you know. And if you want to know, I would say about a half a teaspoon, you know, because I'm only putting it on one side. And then you got your spicy Montreal steak seasoning. Just a couple of shakes. You can always eyeball it, you know, teaspoon or half a teaspoon. You know, whatever your taste buds inquire. All right, my roasted garlic and herb. A little bit of that on there too, which is also gonna be on our potatoes as well. And then once I get it on there like that, as y'all can see, got it on there. Basically, I just do this. I just tap it in, just like that. Tap it in just like that. All right, now, we're gonna get this in my conventional oven. We're gonna start baking that, and we're gonna keep it moving. What I did forget to tell y'all is I am gonna just slice up just a little bit of red onion to put on that steak. You know, when the steak is almost done and I turn it over, I'm gonna put this on there too, so we can have kind of like, you know, a little bit of some good red onions on top of that steak, all right? That's all I wanted to tell you. So what we're doing right now is we letting that steak broil and cook in there for about 20 minutes. Because it's going to be done pretty quick. You know what I'm saying? Then we're going to start on this potato, what I was telling y'all about, what I'm going to be doing, that Hasselback potato. Okay? So, the steaks will be done. Right when the steak is done, we're going to keep it moving. Oh, yeah. And I got the steak on 350 degrees. All right? Let me let y'all see how beautiful that steak looking. Look at this, y'all. Look at that. Looking mighty good, huh? That steak is coming out mighty good. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Y'all see that juice at the bottom? See that juice just shaking at the bottom right there? We're going to be using some of that juice, too, when I make my butter sauce for the potato. Y'all going to see. Let's keep it moving. All right, so the steak is done. So as I told y'all, I'm going to take this. As y'all see, this has that juice in it. You see that juice? I'm simply going to... See that? All that good, yummy, juicy flavor from that steak and some of the seasonings. So I'm just putting that in there like that, okay? Because I'm going to melt my butter in this when we make our sauce, our little buttery sauce that's going to have something to do with that potato, okay? Just wanted to show y'all that. All right, y'all, now let's start on the Hasselback potato. That's what they call it. So I simply got these two sticks. I'm just going to put on the side of this potato. This is to keep the knife from going all the way down. I don't want to slice all the way through it. Only as far down as I can get. We're going to do the whole potato like that. You know? And I'm going to start just like this. With the top part, you know, my little sticks ain't gonna go that far. You just want to do like that. And I'll show y'all in a minute what I'm talking about. This is what I'm talking about. You see what I'm doing? I'm just making like that. Putting a little, like that. So I'm going to do the whole thing, and I'll let you see what that looks like when I'm done. All right, y'all. So I just cut these down. So let me show y'all. I didn't go all the way to the bottom, but this is what it want to look like. Look. Y'all see that? Y'all see where it can open? Y'all see it? It's like with little potato chips. Y'all can see that? Y'all can see. Y'all can see where I'm kind of opening them up so y'all can see what, how I sliced them. I only sliced them down almost, but not all the way through so they can stay in place. Okay? I did a second one too, just in case. This one in the middle, the little potato kind of got cut off a little bit, but it's okay. As y'all can see, it's still good. Still good to go. Okay? So y'all gonna see how this is gonna come out. What I'm about to do now, before I put them in that conventional oven, is we about to make some butter, a buttery sauce. Remember I poured that little steak juice, that we call that what, our ruse? The ruse, I put it in there. So now I'm gonna put this butter in there and then a little bit of olive oil, and then we're gonna melt this butter down, you know, stir it all up real good. And then we're gonna paint them on here with my paintbrush before we put them in that oven, okay? So let's get right to it. Okay, so as y'all see, I just took a whole little stick of butter, put it in here in this bowl where we put our steak juice, I'ma call it. Then I'm gonna take a little extra virgin olive oil. Just gonna pour a little bit, just a little bit of that in there, you know? That's gonna kinda enhance the flavor of the butter and that little ruse we put in there, okay? Now this is gonna go in the microwave. About to make that. Once we do that, we'll finish up on these potatoes before putting them in the conventional oven. Okay, so what I did was I took my pan, I sprayed a little bit of my canola oil on there, the non-stick spray. I put some of that on top of there. I melted my butter and all those juices, as y'all can see right here. Let y'all get a better look. So I got all that, you know, mixed up. So what we're gonna do now is I'm gonna put some salt and pepper in this and start mixing that up too, okay? So that's where that comes in at. So put some pepper in here like so, in our little bowl. Let me put it up here like this. Okay. Go get some of that pepper up in there, like that. All right. Salt. Put a little salt in there. You know, I just always do one little turn, you know, because the salt gonna play another part again in there. Then we're just gonna whisk that up. If you got garlic paste or garlic, you can definitely put it in here too. It's up to you. Okay, so we're gonna get that mixed up and then we're gonna move to the next step. Okay, now that we got that mixed up, we got our paintbrush. Oh, wow, I'm thinking about a toothbrush. I guess because I know this is going to be some good food when I'm done, and that's going to come in handy later. All right, so here we go, y'all. So basically, I'm just going to dip it in here. We're going to take that, going to rub it. Rub it across the potato, just like that. Just like that, all right? Make sure that yummy goodness of this butter that we just did, you know, you paint it on top, just like that, okay? Just like that, paint it on top. All right? What you wanna do too, is try to get the butters inside too. You know, try to get them inside, you know, inside the middle of them, if you can, you know? You have to open them up a little bit. You wanna try to get them all up in there like so. Just like that, you know? Just like that. Move your fingers, move them down a little bit, and get your brush inside there, just like that. You know, get your brush inside there, just like that. All right, just like that. Might have to have your other hand kind of help open them up a little bit. But that's what you want to do, okay? You want to get them in there like that. I'm going to do this other one, then we'll get on with the next step. Okay, y'all, after y'all have them all done, they're going to be looking like this. You know, they all buttered up. I put butter inside the middles of them. I went to, tried to go to each one that I could and do that, put them in there, okay? Now, I got my conventional oven set at 400 degrees for 30 minutes, okay? So we're gonna stick up in there, let them bake for 30 minutes. Then we're gonna bring them out. Gonna put some more butter and stuff on there, put it back in again for maybe half the time, And then they should come out nice and crispy on the outside and nice and fluffy on the inside. And these, my friends, is what you call Hasselback potatoes. Y'all see how they're going to come out at the end. But for now, let's get them in that oven. Let's get the bacon. When they done, we'll be right back. I ain't forgot about y'all. 20 more minutes to go. Oh, yeah, and I did forget to put the red onions on the steak. But that's all right. It's going to be good anyway. But if y'all want to do that, y'all can do that when y'all make it, all right? I forgot because I'm so excited about this. Just had to let y'all know that. I'm still with y'all. Seven more minutes and the first part will be done. All right? I'm still here. Okay, so we only got 5 more minutes left. In the meantime, I'm about to cut up this green onion because I'm going to garnish that over these potatoes when they're finally done, okay? So a few more minutes, that's going to be done. I'm going to let you see what they're looking like because we got to put them back in. We're going to butter them up again and put them back in for 15 more minutes, and then they'll be done. And then we will be to the finish line, all right? So be right back. All right, y'all. They're done. I'm gonna take them out right now. Let y'all see the first phase. Wow, looking so good. Okay, there y'all go. Y'all take a look. That is the first phase right there. See how good it is? Almost like a beehive. You know, so the object is we're gonna put some more butter on top, and then we're gonna put them back inside the conventional oven, which is at that time, it's gonna be crispy on the outside. You know, so we're going to take our butter. We're going to start doing this again. Just like that, all right? So while I get that going, let me get that going. We're going to get them back in there, and we're going to be almost to the finish line. They are now done. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to let y'all see what they look like. Look at that. Yummy, yummy, yummy. These are what you call Hasselback potatoes, y'all. Hasselback potatoes. Looking good. Crispy on the outside and very nice and fluffy on the inside. Okay, that's how we got it right there, y'all. So what I'm gonna do right now, y'all already know, I'm gonna go ahead and get the plating going. I'm gonna throw some of these nice little green onions I chopped up. Put some more butter sauce on here. And then I'm gonna put some salt and pepper again on here. We're gonna get the plating going. Next when we come back, what we all been waiting for, the plating. All right, y'all, we are now done. Came out so good, y'all. So whenever y'all want to do a quick little T-bone steak dinner with a potato, make your potato creative, not just a regular baked potato, all right? Introducing T-bone steak with Hasselback potato. All right, I gotta always try to remember that. That was my first time making that kind of potato too, y'all. The rookie chef, that's what we do. Try things for the first time. So introducing the T-bone steak with Hasselback potato. Y'all tell me what y'all think. Here it is. Yes, indeed. Nice T-bone steak that we broiled. We did that Hasselback potato. I got the green onions in there. I got those red pepper flakes in there. Oh yeah, looking good. T-bone steak with Hasselback potatoes, y'all. Y'all already know this is gonna be so good. I know it's gonna be so good. And this is all you need when you just wanna have a nice little steak and a nice little potato to go with it, y'all. The rookie chef way. Got your steak sauce over there you can put on that steak. I even put some of our nice little butter topping that we made over the steak too. So yeah, we're gonna have all that. But there y'all go. There y'all go, ladies and gentlemen. There y'all go. The T-bone steak with Hasselback potato. Y'all know what time it is. The taste test. Here we go. Let's do it. First, I know that steak is going to be where I want to take it from. Take it from right here. Cut right through it. Like a slice of butter. That butter sauce and the seasoning is real good on the steak. take it so tender. I know it's gonna be good when I put that steak sauce on there. Mm-hmm. Let's try a potato, y'all. One good thing about this, goes together good. Oh my God. That crunch on the outside, softness on the inside. That's what I'm talking about. If a commercial gonna come on, I'm gonna pause it. I'll be right back. Sorry about that, we had a commercial, okay? Let me continue. Now, that potato was so good, you could taste the crispiness on the outside, that baked, so creamy on the inside, all right? Now, the good fun part about this is, let me take another piece of this thing. Man, I don't even need the fork. I don't even need the fork. But you get the piece of steak, right? You cut the piece of steak in, slice off one of these parts of your potato, like so. And then you can do just like this. Now that's what you call steak and potato. I'm gonna tell y'all like this. I love y'all. I tried this idea. They go good together. Y'all gotta try this. Y'all gonna love it. Ricky Chef, y'all. And what better way? What better way, y'all? What better way than to have it with? A cold one. We now about to say our goodbyes. I need to take care of this right here, okay? Time to say our goodbyes and dim the lights. All right, now it's time to say our goodnights. I want to thank y'all for joining me in another Rookie Chef dish. This was fun. This is when you just want you a steak. Man, get a T-bone, do that potato like that. You won't be disappointed. Recap time. We did a T-bone steak with Hasselback potatoes, y'all. There it is. And it came out so good. Okay, there it is. So I want to say thank y'all. Much love. And till next time, I want everybody to stay safe, take care, stay healthy, be blessed. And most importantly, take care of yourself, your wealth, and your health, and your family that's amongst you. Everybody, peace out. I am the Rookie Chef Young Reno, signing off to finish this dish. Don't forget to like and subscribe.